There's another blow for renters, with the market getting even harder. New data this morning revealing the toughest spots in each state to find a rental. Nine's Davina Smith is live in Brisbane. Davina, what does the data show?
Well, Sarah, good morning. Real estate agents are calling these figures horrifying. They've been published in The Australian today, and they highlight 17 postcodes across the country where in December there was just one home available for rent in those locations. In Queensland, we're talking about Ipswich, Rockhampton and Mackay. In New South Wales, it was the Sutherland Shire in Sydney's south, along with Armidale and Inverell. And in Victoria, it's the Yarra Ranges and a number of suburbs across Geelong. And it comes as new details are released today in Queensland that show the number of people on the wait list for social housing. 43,000 people have their name on that wait list. They're people that are sleeping rough at the moment or sleeping with family and have nowhere else to be at the moment. 43,000 people, that's enough people to fill the Gabba or the SCG. An additional 1,600 people were added to that list in the last quarter alone. The government says they are spending record amount of money on social housing, but clearly it's not even touching the sides, Sarah.
No, it is certainly tough out there at the moment. Davina, thank you for the update.
We are joined now by the block judge and real estate expert Marty Fox in Melbourne. Marty, good morning to you. Why is it so important to go into this process with a plan? Because it is stressful, right?
Good morning, guys. Absolutely. And the thing is, so many people spend decades saving to the point to home ownership. So you really have to have your strategy, know your budget, and go into this with a lot of preparation.
All right. So where do you start?
Well, really, it starts with your budget and speaking to your broker and bank and understanding what you can spend and knowing how much the associated costs are, especially if you're buying an apartment, what the owner's corporation fees are, if you're buying a house, all the maintenance that is required, and sticking to your limits is key. I see it week after week where people get caught up in the auction and they bid with emotion and they put themselves in a pretty stressful situation for the future.
Everybody buys more than what they initially went in with, and then you end up in debt, and it's a very stressful process.
And also with Bodycorp, you made a good point there. Mine has just doubled, and it is absolutely killing me. So make sure that the maintenance has all been done, and that's not going to increase as the years go on.
Hey, catches Marty, everyone.
Hey, Marty, how do we narrow down our search?
So really understanding the brief and knowing what your non-negotiables are. For instance, that might be the bedrooms that you need, the amount of bathrooms or the car parking, and being very clear with that, because so many people go on the journey, they miss a few properties, they see things that are okay and they settle for just okay, and then they do regret in the future.
All right, now this is an interesting one. You've eyed off the property and you've got to decide, do you play it cool or do you go in enthusiastically? So where do you go from there once you find what you want?
Well, look, once you find what you want, at the end of the day, you've really got to do your research. Understand values, so know what the property should be selling for and try and stick to that. Build a relationship with the agent that is selling the property and understand the motivation. Because if you can play with things such as terms, deposit sizes and so forth, use that to your advantage moving forward.
So for anyone ready to buy now, you do have some amazing properties to show us, starting with a spectacular beachside home in New South Wales.
Yes, this one is asking $12 million.
Okay.
It is incredible.
So we can strike that one off the list.
A teenager's retreat downstairs, and it's only one of 21 homes in this exclusive enclave, which has the deep water mooring. So really special property and incredible views over the national park. It is a spectacular property.
Does the housekeeper come with that?
You have to ask the sellers if they throw one in.
Too many floors for me. All right, what's on offer? Let's head to Victoria now.
Well, this one here reminds me of a French chateau. It is 3/4 of an acre and it has the most spectacular views over the cliff. This home has imported features all throughout from France. You've got cast iron fountains. You've got marble clad kitchen. This is 5 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms. It's got a 5-car garage, but you buy this home and essentially you're 45 minutes out of Melbourne, but you would feel like you're waking up in the French countryside every day.
That is gorgeous. Hey, what about Queensland?
Well, Queensland, we have something very special here. This home, the year that it was completed, one build of the year. It is a single level, three bedroom, north facing, right in Sanctuary Cove. And this is just luxury to the highest degree. Architect designed, and this would really suit that person that's downsizing, doesn't have the family there. It's three bedrooms, and this is likely to be a bolt hold up north for someone that has worked very hard for their entire lives.
Or 100 million.
Yeah, asking $9 million that last one.
Well, that's not too bad. It seems like a bit of a bargain there. Yeah,
yeah, fair pricing. Yeah.
Hey, Marty, as always, thanks for chatting. See you again soon.